Hello and welcome to a special 10th episode of We Talk Football. It's been a wild ride so far, and we have plenty more to come. But we decided to switch it up a little bit and talk about the Euros.
I mean, come on, Slovakia. I mean, listen, it's a 10th episode. We thought, why to sit here and talk about the Euros? We can do a little fun game with it. So Brandon and I, we're going to do a bracket challenge battle. And it's going to last throughout the whole Euro. So we're going to pick our bracket challenge now. And we're going to count every thing we get right is a 1 point. All right. And at the end of the Euros, we count out how many points we got. And the winner wins. And the loser, what's the loser going to get, Brandon?
A forfeit.
Which probably require us spending money. Which, in this kind of economy, I'm not trying to lose.
In this economy?
Good thing I won't lose. But enough talk, Brandon. Let's just jump right into it. I want to see who you got winning this tournament.
So, for sure. So, the Euros, as we know, is actually a really tough competition to call every year. There's always someone different coming in. There's always a few different dark horses. And this year is no different. So, we're going to go group by group, predicting who's going to make it into the next round. And then we're going to tell you our predictions.
All right.
So, Group A. It's a pretty open group. I think every single team in it actually has a good chance. So you have Switzerland, who has the likes of Xhaka and Jordan Shaqiri. Turkey, who has quite a few players on league team who won the league. We have Wales, who last year was one of those dark horses. They made it to the round of 16. And Italy, who they haven't been good recently. But their fans are saying this might be their year again. So for me, I'm going to go with Italy first. We're going to go Turkey second, and then Wales third, and then Switzerland is going to miss out.
Jeez. Okay. Bold on Turkey second. Okay, but I like it. I like it.
So heading over to Group B. This is another sort of open group, but first things first, I just got to put it out there. Belgium. One of the favorites. They're taking first place.
All right.
Russia hosted the last World Cup, and they really showed out. But I'm not going to put them second. I'm actually going to go with Denmark second, because their midfield, their team chemistry is... It's just...
That you had...
If you watch any of their games, you know that they play well together. So I'm going with them second. Russia third. And Finland... There's not much to Finland. They're hard workers, but I don't think they're making it through against the likes of Thor. I said Thorgan Hazard, but the two Hazard brothers, Lukaku, who might be the top goal scorer, and Kevin De Bruyne when he returns. So we got to go Belgium on top. And then Group C.
Ooh. Are you really thinking that hard about this? This is pretty easy. Come on, man.
Like, okay, Netherlands.
Come on.
Young core. No Virgil van Dijk, though. They still have De Ligt in the back.
That's fine.
I don't know about their goalie situation. Is Tim Krul really going to play another tournament?
Why not? I mean, I think this is probably the easiest groups, in my opinion.
Easiest groups?
Yeah. What? It's MK Dons, whatever that team is, Macedonia. It's MK Dons.
Are you sick in the mind? Are you that mentally enslaved?
Whatever it's called. I don't even know what the name is.
Macedonia? Don't they have Jovetic and Panda? Two good strikers.
They're coming third place. Are you ahead of Ukraine?
Not a chance. Ukraine.
Austria ahead of Ukraine. Okay.
Well, Ukraine might even make it to the next round. And okay. This is a group everyone's looking at. Everyone in England.
It's coming home.
A few too many right backs for my liking. There's no real tactics. This might be controversial. We're putting them third.
Fam, what?
Huh?
We're putting them third.
Third for England, third.
England is going to be third. You heard it here first. There's too many things around the squad. The team chemistry is not where it should be. And... Have you watched any of their games? Because they have no tactics other than set pieces.
You're telling me Scotland or Czech Republic are going to finish ahead of them. Do you watch the qualifying games for Scotland? They came through the Euros on pens. Czech Drug Republic is decent, but they're not really. You're saying that. Okay, you know what? Go ahead. This is my chance to sneak through, get some extra points. You're the one getting the forfeit.
Croatia is going to be top team. They had an amazing World Cup. Their midfield of Rakitic, Modric, and even Kovacic, a lot of itches, but like, they are going to be top of this group, but I don't see them going too far. And then, Czech Republic. I just got a feeling. And then Scotland, I think, is going to take points off of England, but they're not going to make it through. Another easy group?
Excuse me. This is not an easy group. What is easy about this group? Fam, what is this disrespect? What is this disrespect, bro? No, okay, you know what? Go ahead.
You're telling me they're going to go through against Spain?
Yes. We're coming third. We're taking points off Poland. Watch it right here. First game, Monday. We're taking off points off Poland. We're finishing out of Sweden, too. Sweden second? Fam, this guy.
Alexander Isak. 6'4 striker, played for Dortmund.
Fam.
He's scoring goals.
Okay.
Mark my words.
This guy is mental right now, bro. Lewandowski's
finishing third.
What? Let me see. You're going to put Hungary first in this group? Is this what you're going to do? You know there's a forfeit, right?
Yeah. This one, Hungary's actually a good team.
I know. People are sleeping on them, but they're not beating any of these teams, bro. But knowing you, you're going to put them first.
Germany's okay. They don't have that fear factor that they once had.
Have you seen their roster?
Their roster is nice, but I can't trust them.
Okay. You trust Portugal?
The likes of France, who has the most depth.
I can agree with that. They've
shown that they can win
on tournament favorites.
Yeah. They're just built for tournaments. Mbappe plays great in big games. And then on the other side, you have Portugal. Great going forward. Their midfield is pretty strong. You just can't bet against Portugal.
Honestly, when you have Ronaldo. Most people have that order, but I know I'm going to switch it up. Don't worry about it.
And Hungary, they're a decent side. It's just, I just don't think.
There's no way against they're coming down. They're not getting out there. All right, let's see your top four. So in the Euros, how's it going to work? The four best third place teams will be going up. So obviously, goal difference is going to matter. Probably yellow cards are going to matter as well. So, Brandon, who you got going through?
So for me going through, this is where I sort of make my plea to England fans. They'll make it through. And it's probably a bit better that they come third rather than first, or else they would have had to face the likes of France. So this is probably your best wish. Germany's going to make it through. Russia will make it through. And so will Wales.
Okay, you know what? I'm not going to talk or anything. All right, let's see this.
First round, Belgium. Stopping them up.
I thought you said better that they're going to come third, and this makes no sense. Yeah, we're going to play Belgium. That's the best thing. No.
Would you rather face France?
France is coming first. England's coming first. You don't play first versus first. So that's my opinion, but okay.
Oh, you're saying England's first? Oh, okay, we'll see. Belgium just has too much quality. England, they take too long to gel in tournaments, and I don't think they'll have enough time to really... They won't be challenged as much in their group other than Croatia. So I don't think they'll have what it takes against a team like Belgium, who always plays well together. Most of their players know each other, and they just blend well, especially when it comes to attacking.
Fair enough.
Italy, this should be your year. Austria has basically only David Alaba, not much else. I'll put that forward. France against Russia.
You're really taking that long? Really, bro? Really? What? France has probably gotten better since the World Cup.
We all counted out Russia.
Okay, Russia's good, but they're not beating France, dog. Yeah. You know what? Put Russia. Go ahead. Put Russia, actually.
No.
Go ahead. Put Russia.
I'm just saying, it might be a little something there. Sweden. They're going to score goals. Mark my words. Spain. That's easy. Ooh. Croatia, Portugal.
You have Croatia going first, bro. There's no way they're losing to Portugal then.
Portugal is a good side.
So is Croatia.
They're both. That's a toss-up. I'll go with Croatia. Netherlands, Germany. For some reason, I don't trust Germany in these.
I'm not gonna say that. I'm gonna keep it for mine. No, keep going. Go for Netherlands, bro. Go ahead. Put Netherlands.
Netherlands. I think they're too young.
Okay. Okay. This one is easy then.
These are two dark horses.
Okay, but Turkey is the. You know what? Pick Denmark.
Oh, yeah. Denmark. I'm going Denmark straight up.
Okay.
Christian Eriksen will show up. Belgium, Italy. Belgium.
Eriksen never show up. Come on now.
Too much quality in that side. France. We'll go Croatia. Beating Spain. Spain, you can't bring no Real Madrid players. You have to expect better.
All right.
And then Denmark again going through.
Fam, what is KO? Fam, I'm getting so many points. Bro, I can't wait for your back to be busted when Denmark doesn't even make it out.
They'll make it out.
They probably will.
Schmeichel and Ned.
All right, what do you have here?
This one, I have no clue. Because Belgium, I think the only team that actually pushes them is France. But France sets up nicely. I think France tactically is better, and they have the better personnel. So I will go France. And then Croatia, Denmark. Croatia is going
to. So we're getting a rematch of the World Cup final from 2018. Yep.
And it's going to be France, because that's what they do.
All right, so not a bad, you know. Okay, so it's not a bad bracket. I mean, the winner is pretty expected, but you made some questionable choices there, Brandon.
I for sure did, and I'm going to stick by it, because I feel like 2021, we've seen so many of those big teams fall off, and on the international stage, why can't we be seeing the same thing? We already see a lot of dark horses in the Euros on occasion, so I think it could be on the same lines.
All right, if you say so, but that means before it's my turn.
But like, you know,
it's Zagwe break. All right, guys, it is time for me to pick the winning bracket in all ways. I just want to say, I won the March Madness bracket out of the whole league. Brandon knows this. Brandon came all the way at the bottom. I was first.
This guy decided to pick the highest seed in every single game.
Not true.
Of course. There's no point in playing like that.
All right, then that's fine. I'm going to win this. All right, it is my turn. Honestly, Group A, I have to agree with Brandon. Italy's going first. But this is actually low-key hard, because Switzerland, they're kind of dark horse in this. Wales, they're decent, but I don't know. But I think Turkey is a low-key kind of team that they can sneak through. Now, third and fourth, I have to agree with Brandon. I think Wales takes it, Switzerland. Group B now. Belgium easily. Russia is coming second. I know you had someone else at second. I think you had Denmark. I think Russia, this team is just... I was very impressed with them from the World Cup, and I think they're going to come second. Denmark will come third. Finland, sorry, Pookie, you're going fourth. Group C.
In like a year? Like
Dutch take it easily. Ukraine, I think their team's solid enough to take second. Austria third. Over Austria. You're hearing it here first. Ukraine is coming second. Group D. See, now this is the normal picks. England is coming first. I have them coming first. Followed by Croatia, Czech Republic, Scotland's coming last. I just don't see England. Okay, maybe England comes second, but they're for sure not going third place, Brandon. First, I think...
Who did England lose to in the World Cup?
What?
Who did England lose to in the World Cup?
Croatia. But they only have to play Croatia once, so I'm just saying. I just think this England team, they have too much, like... I think they're ready to come play. The players they brought on this year, they're young, and I think compared to the World Cup squad, I know there's a lot of returners, but I think they're going to come first in this one. Now, in Group E, Podmislovensko, right? Podmislovensko, come on! But Spain's coming first.
Oh, I thought you were about to put Slovakia first.
Relax, I'm not stupid. Second is hard, all right?
Is it?
It's between Poland and Sweden. And I think Poland, Lewandowski, the way he's playing, I think I'm with my gut, I think Poland's going to come. Slovakia's going third. Sweden.
Are you going to say second is between two teams, and then you're going to put Slovakia above that?
Oh. Actually, you know what? No. Sweden is going here. Slovakia is going third place. Poland's coming fourth in the thing.
You just said your gut is with Lewandowski.
I'm changing it up here. Remember, I won the March Madness bracket. Podmis Slovensko, Slovakia is coming third. You heard it here first. Poland is coming fourth. Sweden's team is kind of nasty. I think Poland. No, you know I'm going with gut feeling. I can't do it. Going gut feeling. This one, France, Germany, Portugal, Hungary. You don't have faith in Germany. I do. Now we're going here. Portugal for sure. This is where it gets hard, though. This is where it gets hard.
Teams in there.
Denmark, I have to pick. Czech Republic, I have to pick. So now, I have Slovakia, Austria, and Wales to pick from. I need one more. Who am I going to go? This is actually very hard. I think Wales pulls it off. Sorry, Slovakia. I think you're going out in this. You're going to come third, but I don't think you're going to qualify next. I think this is it. So we go on the next stage. This is the easy one. See, this is what makes sense now. Belgium easily beats Czech Republic. Italy easily goes through. This is a hard matchup. France, Denmark. France goes through, though. Croatia, Poland. Croatia goes through. Spain goes through here. This now is going to be interesting.
See, that's the problem when you put England top of the group.
That's regardless, though, because they're going to play the group of death. So
if they get third, they got an easy...
Okay. If they get second, they play France.
Yeah, which means they're going home.
They're going home regardless, because Germany is going to beat England. Portugal is going through. England
guys further in the tournament, but...
Russia is going through.
Over dark horses, Turkey.
You heard it here first. Russia is the dark horse, actually, if you think about it. This is hard, but Belgium's going through. This now. This is what I want to see. A France-Croatia World Cup rematch in the quarters, though. I just see France going through. Spain, Germany, Germany goes through. Portugal, Russia, Portugal goes through. Now, this is the hard part. Honestly, I won't lie. This is my second bracket I'm making. All right, I have another one I already made for my own fantasy league. But in this terms of WTF, we gotta have some content. Belgium beats France. Here, we're gonna have Portugal. Portugal's making the final back-to-back. Unfortunately, Belgium wins it. I have Belgium winning this whole thing. Give me that save. Give me that save. That's honestly, I could have been boring and gone with France.
As you already took all the number
one. But you want to talk, you know, you want to talk like, oh, you always took the big thing. It's fine. You know what? You made so many mistakes in your own bracket challenge that I'm going to get enough points in the group stage that even if I don't pick the right winner, I'm still making the money, which means you're going to have to probably buy me a jersey as your forfeit. So just, you know, save your money up, Brandon. But that's all we have. The special episode of WTF, the 10th episode. Thank you guys for watching 10 episodes. I'm happy we're still doing this. Euros, we're going to have a lot of Euro analysis and content throughout the next couple of weeks. Again, the Euros start Friday, June 11th, 3 p.m. I think. Italy takes on Turkey. Pretty big. In terms of Slovakia, we play Monday against Poland at 12. That's all I'm going to be watching. I'm telling you, we're taking points off Poland. Mark it down. If we not, guess what? You'll hear about it on next week's episode of WTF. Make sure to hit the subscribe button. Smash the like button. Brandon, anything else to say?
You know what? Instead of me buying a jersey for Eddie, if I lose, I'll get it for one of you guys.
That's fair. In the comments. That's fair. I'll take that. You know, I don't need another jersey. It's fine. But that's all we have for this week. Peace. You got one try, then I'm leaving. Yeah, I'm leaving. Ice on me, man. I got diamonds, but they say that I don't need them. She gon' need me. When she need me. I've been rolling through my thoughts and you can't beat me. You sick in the mind? Are you that mentally enslaved and intellectually subservient and intellectually molested and ideologically molested?